You can't ban Norman from the cafeteria. It's a public place.
But you understand why I'm doing it, right? It's nothing personal.
You think Norman's been exposed to something tapu?
Yes. I just want to protect baby in here.
Yeah, I can understand that.
So, we're good. No problem.
I'm afraid there is. You can't exclude someone because of your spiritual beliefs.
Look, I lost my first baby because I didn't know how to look after him properly while I was pregnant. And there is no way that I'm going to do that again.
Then maybe you should think about starting your maternity leave early. Because banning Norman or anyone is unacceptable.
I thought you of all people, you'd understand.
Because I'm Māori too. I thought I told you, playing that card with me doesn't work. By the way, the new contract for the cap? Why don't you and Tama see what you think and get back to me?
Why are you doing this?
What do you mean?
Have you got some kind of problem with being Māori?
No, of course not.
You have done nothing but find fault with me and Tama. Here was me thinking that we might actually get a bit of tautoko.
I'm trying to do what's best for the hospital, that's all.
Oh, lovely.
See that? Mm.
Before, you were asking Tony out here?
To join us tonight, yeah, so?
Well, I don't know, mate, you tell me.
Oh, you think I'm making a play for Tony? After everything she's been through, how insensitive do you think I am?
Like I said, you tell me.
Well, I've just invited Yvonne as well. Suppose that means I'll be trying to score her next.
Oh, just tell me straight, Hugo. You and Tony, yes or no?
No. Yes. No.
Come on, can you be serious for just 1 minute? Chris and Tony are mates of mine, and they're going through a bloody awful time at the moment.
Yeah, so all the more reason why her mates should be trying to put a smile on her face. You saw her before. She was laughing until her ex came along.
He's not her ex yet.
It is over between them.
Yeah, and you thought you'd just sweep on in there then, eh?
First you think I'm a stalker, and now I'm a total sleaze. Like, Tony's hot, yeah?
Yeah.
You okay?
But the difference is I would never go there, and neither should you.
You're just not believing me here.
You know why? It's because I know you better than that, so just back off. Give her and Chris a chance to sort things out, and maybe they might be able to get through all this.
Okay. One orientation plan, as requested.
Good. Thanks.
By the way, if you're thinking of making any more changes to ED...
Yes.
I would appreciate being kept in the picture.
Of course.
Just checking. You obviously like to keep some things close to your chest.
You mean me and Stephen? Okay, let's get this straight. Feel free to judge me on my professional performance. It's what I expect. But my private life, it's my business.
If only it were that simple. You really think you can keep them separate?
Yes, and I do.
What, by bonking the DHB member responsible for negotiating our contracts? Yeah, very separate.
Strangely enough, Stephen and I didn't spend our time talking about work.
Well, maybe you should have. Chris still doesn't know whether the plastics contract is being renewed. Oh, but of course, that couldn't possibly have anything to do with your little fling. As you said, working life, private life, totally unrelated.
I know. I'm sorry you've been inconvenienced. Someone will be in touch soon to give you a new date for your procedure.
Dr. Chen?
Yes, but I can't see anyone without an appointment. Did you not hear what I just said?
I have an appointment. At least I did have. Tomorrow, to get this removed. Trouble is, you cancelled it.
I'm sorry, Ms...
Robertson. Beth Robertson.
Ms. Robertson. There's nothing I can do.
We're going to have to think of something then. Because I'm staying right here.
Okay, thanks, Craig. Bye. You said Robin gave me benzo or something or other. It's a sedative.
Cool.
Your dad still hates me.
Who cares? He's not worth worrying about.
Yeah, but I'm sick of everyone thinking I'm so evil. Even you thought I'd taken off with some guy, right?
No. Yes. I was dumb. I was in a real spin. I just didn't know what to think. I'm sorry. It just means so much to me that sometimes I get this big fear that I'm losing you.
As if. Like I don't know how lucky I am. Are you still at Simon's?
Yeah.
Is it okay?
For now. Don't suppose you've changed your mind about us getting a place together?
I can't. can't do anything that might stress Andrew out. And plus, I want to be with him, you understand?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, thank God you're all right.
I'm so sorry.
It's not your fault.
Where's Robin? She was so nuts.
She's gone now.
She wants to be alone with you so bad that she locks me up and then she just leaves. But she wanted you back.
Well, she's finally accepted that there's no chance of that. She's out of our lives for good now.
It was a surgeon when I was a kid.
I don't know why you're telling me.
I was having my appendix out, and while I'm in there, he just decides to take the small off my cheek.
Obviously, he shouldn't have.
Yeah, ugly, isn't it? I've been on the waiting list for years. Twice, I've been days away from having it removed. Then I get cancelled, and now you're doing it again.
All I can say is sorry.
I'm getting married in 6 weeks.
You could go private.
With a wedding to pay for? And we've just put a deposit on a house. The operation would cost $4,000.
I can't help you. It's just not up to me.
I'm sure you can find a way. It's all I could scrape together. $1,000. It is yours if my op doesn't get cancelled.